Hello, beautiful soul. I hope you're well. Today, I'd like to share some steps with you that you can take in order to find the time, or actually, let's say, make the time for your passions. First and foremost, I want to talk about self-discipline and priorities. And I know how hard it can be to get out of an unhealthy cycle, but in the end, no one is gonna take this responsibility from you. If you have something that you're passionate about, if you have something you want to accomplish in this life, it is your job and your job alone to actually make it happen, to make the time for it. And in every moment, you have the power to decide different. Right now, you can decide, okay, from now on, I'm gonna go full steam. I don't care what it takes. I'm gonna make this happen because I am so passionate about it. And I know that if I don't go after what I love, I will feel miserable and I will feel unfulfilled. And I will wake up one day wishing that I had started right now. All right, let's talk about time management. Time management can seem like quite a hard nut to crack, especially when you're stuck in a cycle that just makes you feel like there's no time. So it comes down to knowing how you tick. And by that I mean, like, are you a morning or an evening person or a night person or day person? Like, when are you most efficient? When do you feel like the clearest in your head, in your mind? Are you the kind of person that, you know, once you're done with your work, you get home or you are home and you want to do nothing more than just take time for self-care, whatever that may look like for you? If that is you, my recommendation for you is to actually, yes, take time for self-care, but then go to bed early. Make sure you sleep at least 6 hours because, you know, your body, your brain, everything needs time to rejuvenate and to process whatever happened that day. And then wake up early. Wake up early. It's so important. If you want to have time for what you're passionate about, you have to make time for it. And it doesn't have to be much. It just can be, you know, an hour, maybe 2 hours in the morning. And if you switch this rhythm to going to bed earlier and then waking up earlier, you will actually feel excited because you are putting in the time for what you're passionate about. And you're slowly building this momentum to actually do what you love. And that momentum is what is going to change your life. What will make you feel fulfilled because you are actually going after your passions. And that is so, so important. And guys, if you are not putting in the time for your passions, nothing is gonna change. Like, it's only through these little steps, through this momentum that you're building, that you are actually slowly changing your life. So first thing I want you to think about, what kind of person are you and how can you make time for what you're passionate about? And again, it doesn't have to be a lot of time. It can be an hour a day. It can be, I don't know, 3 hours a week. Maybe your schedule is super full. Put it in your calendar. Set a timer and make it happen. All right, and lastly, I want to touch upon distractions. If there's a certain habit, something that you do that really takes away a lot of your time and you just wish you could reduce that or maybe even eliminate that completely, though eliminating something like right away is usually a bad idea because your body will be craving it. So just like slowly reducing that is usually the best way to go about it. And let's say you're the kind of person that before you go to bed, you're like lying there and you're on your phone and you're just like scrolling and scrolling and scrolling and scrolling and then, oh my God, another hour has passed and I should be sleeping. If that is you, then you're not alone. And there are certain things that can help you. Like, you can reduce your screen time. There are certain apps out there that keep you from accessing certain apps or they like tell you, okay, now you've spent another hour on your phone. There are things that will help you be aware of taking better management of your time. Or if there are certain things in your room or on your computer that really distract you, make note of that, like be conscious about that and try to reduce that. Like if there's a shortcut on your desktop for your favorite computer game, maybe it shouldn't be there. Maybe you can put it somewhere else or like hide it or something. If there's something in your room that really distracts you and then once you get home, it's like you want to do that right away, maybe you can hide it somewhere in your closet or I don't know what it is, but there are ways to go about it that will really help you make the best of the time that you have, and that is your goal. Before I end this video, I'd like to do a quick recap. I want you to remember that every moment you have the power to decide different, to start a new path, to do better. And there's no shame involved in that. We are constantly learning, we're constantly evolving and growing, and we can just decide that now is the moment that I'm actually taking charge of what I want, that I'm making time for my passions and for my goals. After that, I want you to think about, how do you tick? Are you a morning person? Are you an evening person? When do you feel most energized? And when during the day or during the week can you make time for your passions, for your goals? Put it in your calendar, set a timer, set a reminder, make it happen. And lastly, eliminate distractions. Think about what is taking time away from you and how can you reduce that. I wish you so much joy, so much excitement for this journey of going after your passions, and I know that you will feel amazing once you incorporate these new habits. You got this. So much love from me to you, and have a nice day.